kept you waiting long enough, I think. We're going to play a little game here. So Dan and Kristen have hooked me up with beautiful logos, thanks to Dan, and we found some songs. So we're going to play a little bit of a song. If you know the title, shout it out. Go for it. We're starting with the Kiwanis Studio Theater first. So we have 5 shows in the season for this show, this space.
Ready?
Ready.
I'll give you cards for Childhouse in Turtle Bay and a fur and a diamond ring.
This is a hard one.
And we'll be married in Spain on my yacht today.
Yeah. And so it's Songs for a New World. If you're not familiar with this, it's a Jason Robert Brown show. Beautiful score. More of a review than a book show. We'll be doing, it's got gospel, jazz, all sorts of beautiful songs put together with the idea that these different generations of people are traveling in some sort of way to a new world. On to the next one. You ready, Karen?
Yep.
You're up. Carol Merrill is in place. Go.
It is astounding. Time is fleeting.
Yeah, so this is a first for us. We've never had the live show on our stage before. We've done the movie version before. But we thought it'd be a fun kind of celebrate Halloween with us. So it's going all the way to October 31st. So come out and enjoy it with us. Now this next one's going to be a little bit harder, a lot harder. But let's see what... Go for it. This is a play, and this is actually for the soundtrack from that play. It could be 1,000 things, I know. I'm just going to tell you. It's Crimes of the Heart. Now this show, if you're not familiar with it, is about 3 sisters in Mississippi. They reunite and they kind of all discuss their own crimes of their heart. All right. I'm just going to tell you the next one. We're going to play a piece from it, but you'll never guess it. But it's a Tennessee Williams play. It is The Glass Menagerie. Tom is the lead character, and he has a very difficult mother who's trying to get him to find a husband for his handicapped sister, Laura. So excited about that one. All right, the last one. You ready?
Yes. Ready?
Yep, go clear.
Everyone should have something to point to, something to be proud of. Look what I did, see what I've done.
Everybody's like, I know it.
I was the one. Everyone should have something to point to, some way to be tall in the crowd. See that building day after day.
All right.
Day after day.
It is working, yes, working. Yay. This kind of celebrates the American laborer in all different areas. And a fun spin that we're doing, there's a new version of this show where you go into your own community and you highlight some of your local people. So we're talking about maybe using Tropicana or Bells, or we're going to go there and interview them and then integrate it into our show. So really exciting. All right, we're moving on to the main stage. Are you ready?
Welcome to the Renaissance.
We got the expert down here, yes. So, of course, Welcome to the Renaissance is that the song that we most know from this show. And the Renaissance is full of black plague and soothsayers who give you bad information and sends a couple of brothers off to create a play. The soothsayer sees a future where plays include song and dance, but they get it a little wrong, so they do, instead of Hamlet the music, they do Omelet the music. So it's a lot of fun, a lot of tap dancing, a lot of great music. Excited about that. Okay, moving on. I think he gets another star just for this. Yeah, Drowsy Chaperone. Of course, this is about a fictional 1920s musical that the guy in chair tied takes us through that whole history. And moving on. This is going to be an easy one.
She loves me.
You can all say it. Y'all get it.
I love it. Knowing that she loves
me. So this is about a small shop perfumery, or what word could we say today, where a couple of people hate each other in the shop, but they realize that they've actually been sending love letters back and forth as pen pals. So it's a lot of fun. It's perfect for the holidays. It does have a holiday theme kind of built into it, and a wonderful family show. All right, this next one, if you all don't get it, I'm giving your, taking all your board cards back. All right. Oklahoma, of course you all know this show, Rodgers and Hammerstein classic. A little bit of backstory is, you think that this would be so easy because it's done so often for us to get the rights to. I've been trying for about 4 years, so this is the first time I could actually get a yes from them, so I'm excited about that. All right, the next one.
It means cancel all your parties.
This one's hard.
Forget your big parade.
Hooray!
You
can make it too hard. Yeah, parade. If you're not familiar with that, exciting that it is just now going back to Broadway. So I got in that little window where they would give us the contract. But it's about a Jewish man who gets falsely accused of rape, and it's actually a true story. And it's why the Anti-Defamation League was actually formed, because of this story. All right, the last one, and we're ready on standby. Yay. So I thought it was kind of fun that we're kind of opening the season and closing the season with Shakespeare-inspired shows. Of course, it's about the retelling of The Taming of the Shrew and The Battle of the Sexes. Really excited about this season. I hope that you are. I think it's a season that will get people back in our doors and not so afraid of COVID. So let's hope that happens. And thank you, everybody, for supporting us. Thank you, thank you. With that, I'm going to turn it back over to the community.